Reverse ptosis, also referred to as upside-down ptosis, is elevation of the lower eyelid relative to its normal position at the level of the inferior corneal limbus. Broadly, the causes of reverse ptosis are mechanical and neurologic. The mechanical causes are mainly due to weakening or disinsertion of lower lid retractors and dystopia, that is, malposition of the globe. The first can be due to involutional, that is, aging changes, trauma, or surgery. Surgery can cause reverse ptosis either due to direct injury to the lower lid retractors, intraoperative speculum use, or residual eyelid malposition. Globe dystopia may be a part of anatomical orbital dystopia or due to in-ophthalmos. Now, coming to the neurologic causes. The capsulopalpebral fascia is formed by the lower lid retractors. The inner division of the capsulopalpebral fascia is composed of the inferior tarsal muscle, whilst the outer division is composed of muscle fibers from the inferior rectus. So this is the orbicularis, this is the inferior rectus, this is the inferior oblique, this is the inferior tarsal muscle, which forms the inner part of the capsulopalpebral fascia. These are the fibers derived from the inferior rectus. The inferior tarsal muscle is supplied by the sympathetic, while the fibers derived from the inferior rectus are supplied by the oculomotor. Thus, involvement of either of these two nerves, that is, Horner syndrome and oculomotor palsy, can result in reverse ptosis. In Horner syndrome, reverse ptosis in combination with upper lid ptosis gives the appearance of an apparent in-ophthalmos. The reverse ptosis in these two conditions is a subtle finding and not always present, but when it is, can be helpful for diagnosis in doubtful cases of Horner syndrome. The condition may either be asymptomatic, or the patient can complain of obscuration of vision and down gaze. Induced astigmatism in a post-LASIK patient has been reported. It was surmised that the thinner and less stiff corneas in post-LASIK patients can make them more vulnerable to eyelid malposition-induced corneal astigmatism. The patient may also be concerned about aesthetics. Clinically, reverse ptosis can be measured as a decrease in the MRD2, which is normally around 5 mm. Lower eyelid retractor function can be evaluated by measuring lower eyelid excursion in down gaze, which is normally around 3 to 4 mm. Treatment of reverse ptosis is essentially surgical. The type of surgical intervention depends on the cause. In the case of globe dystopia or in-ophthalmos, the globe position and orbital volume has to be addressed prior to eyelid surgery. When the globe is in the normal position, either advancement of the lower lid retractors or an inferior tarsal muscle conjunctivectomy may be performed. So that's it for today. See you in the next video.